Hello, Simmers! We are back on more PMDG news for Xbox. We learned from PMDG CEO Robert Rondando that the PMDG team is working hard with some Xbox users and other development teams to improve the buttons, knobs, and switches actions with an Xbox controller, and also to fix the spinning knob issue that some may have experienced. I was quite surprised to learn that the 900 and the 600 variant of the 737 were going to be released already. I was expecting a release later this year, but I was wrong. Unfortunately, they changed a bit their plan because I quote, "We are using those two as test bed for the fixes, so I expect the progress into the marketplace will be slowed just a bit while we build out a resolution to these issues for Xbox users." So those two variants are less expensive. The 900 is around $50 and the 600 is indicated at $35 currently on PMDG website. So even if those planes are less common in real life, it's a very good way to access those very high-end PMDG aircraft. Regarding the tablet, well, it looks like they found minor issues that need to be corrected, and thus it pushes its release even further. So at this moment, remember that we still don't know if the EFB will also be added to the Xbox version. Moving on, the livery pack for the 737 and the DC6 on Xbox. We still have no date for their release. PMDG says they learned a lot recently on the release process on the marketplace and that they are working closely with Microsoft to release the package as soon as possible. So that's nice to see that Microsoft is working closely with them, but as I said in the first place, there is no date yet, which is a bit annoying. And finally, the 777. They said that some progress have been made and lessons learned from the 737 on Xbox with the controls, and that they have refactored it completely. So what I understand with this statement is that the 777 is completely developed to be released on Xbox as soon as possible, and that we won't have to wait a year after the PC release. Unfortunately, there is no preview yet. They've just been able to test the system inside the sim environment, so we still don't have no picture and the development is ongoing. And that's the end of the video, guys. In conclusion, patient we need to be, as always. Have fun, see you soon.